I'm sure you know that 3 plus 2 equals 5, but did you know that Tim plus space plus Buchalka equals Tim Buchalka? Find out how that's possible in this video. My name actually is Tim Buchalka, and I'm from the Learn Programming Academy, and this is my Learn to Code series. So in addition to learning that Tim plus space plus Buchalka equals Tim Buchalka, we're also going to talk about some more programming fundamentals that are typically found in every programming language, and that's because knowing about them will help you to apply them in any programming language you may want to learn. Combining variables, constants, arrays, and objects within a program to do something, like adding two numbers to produce a result, introduces us to the next programming concepts of expressions, operators, and operator precedence. These three terms stem mostly from arithmetic and mathematics, but don't let that freak you out. I think you will see that they're quite easy to understand, and you might ultimately realize that you often use such concepts in your everyday conversations, albeit not when specifically talking about math or arithmetic. So there's two basic types of operators, arithmetic and assignment. The arithmetic operators include add, subtract, multiply, and divide using the plus symbol, the minus symbol, the asterisk symbol, and the forward slash symbol. There are others depending on your programming language, but we're going to limit these to just these four for now. The assignment operator is the equal symbol and is generally used to communicate that a result will be computed by completing the mathematical operation on the right-hand side of the equal sign and place the result into a symbolic memory location on the left side of the equal sign. The mathematical operation is the expression, and operator precedence, or order of operations, determines the order in which parts of a mathematical expression are evaluated. A definition of expression in a programming language is a combination of one or more constants, variables, arrays or objects, along with operators that the programming language interprets and computes to produce another value. All right, so that's a lot of definitions for you. However, the basics of arithmetic and mathematics are in play here. Working through an expression left to right, the rules of math say to do multiply and divide before any addition or subtraction. Now, I'm purposely not talking about the use of parentheses in an expression to keep this as simple as possible. So let's work through an arithmetic example. I want to again add two numbers like we did in the last video, so add these together and obtain a result. In arithmetic, it would look something like this: 17 plus 25 equals 42, or we could say 42 equals 17 plus 25. In a programming language, the programmer would write a statement like you can see on screen there using the symbolic names we've already mentioned. So here it's result number equals first number plus second number. And when this program executes, 17 would be stored in the memory location named first number, 25 would be stored in the memory location named second number, and 42 would be stored in the memory location result number after the computer performed the adding of the two numbers together to yield the result. One final thought here. This discussion pertained to computations working with numbers, but computers can also handle alphabetic and character data manipulation as well. Here's an example. So let's say I have three symbolic memory location names called given name, family name, and full name. The data value stored in the given name memory location is Tim. The data value stored in the family name is Buchalka. Using the assignment expression here, full name equals given name plus family name will result in the full name memory location being assigned the value Tim Buchalka with no white space between the given and family name. In order to have a space between them, the programmer would need an assignment expression like this one. Full name equals given name plus two double quotes plus family name, where the double quotes have a white space character stored within it, thus resulting in Tim space Buchalka being stored in the full name memory location. Oh my gosh, I hope your brain doesn't hurt from all of this. Now, much, much more could be said about these concepts, but let's limit it to what we've covered and move on to the third and final video covering programming language concepts coming up. Did you know that there's three and only three basic building blocks that exist in all programming languages? Find out what they are in the next video. Thanks for watching. Alrighty, this is the part of the video where I'm meant to get all enthusiastic and to ask you, or quite literally beg you, to subscribe to my channel and to like the video, leave a comment, and all that stuff. Well, I'm going to leave that decision in your capable hands to decide whether I've earned a like or a subscribe or a comment. I'd be grateful if you do one, both, or all three. My videos will get out there and in front of a bigger audience if I get that level of engagement, but obviously it's your choice. All right, so remember that this series was meant to be watched in order. So if you haven't watched from the start, then how dare you watch my video series out of order? Click the link over here to get to the first video in the series and watch that if you want to see the entire series in order. Or come over here and click to view the previous video in the series. Again, your choice. All right, I'm done. Catch you in the next video.